Good morning and welcome. Today, the Mass setting is the Mass of Christ the Savior. Please stand and join in singing our opening song, number 545, O God Beyond All Praising, number 545.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we begin this Mass, let us first call to mind our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess
to Almighty God,
and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words,
what I have done, and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask the most Mary and Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Thank you. Let us pray.
O God, who teach us that you abide in hearts that are just and true, grant that we may be so fashioned by your grace as to become a dwelling pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, if someone has on his skin a scab or pustule or blotch, which appears to be the sore of leprosy, he shall be brought to Aaron the priest, or to one of the priests among his descendants. If the man is leprous and unclean, the priest shall declare him unclean by reason of the sore on his head. The one who bears the sore of leprosy shall keep his garments rent and his head bare, and shall muffle his beard. He shall cry out, unclean, unclean. As long as the sore is on him, he shall declare himself unclean, since he is in fact unclean. He shall dwell apart, making his abode outside the camp. The word of the Lord.
Glad in the Lord and rejoice, you just.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. Avoid giving offense, whether to the Jews or Greeks or the Church of God. Just as I tried to please everyone in every way, not seeking my own benefit, but that of the many, that they may be saved. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Gospel according to Mark. A leper came to Jesus and kneeling down, begged him and said, "If you wish, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand, touched him, and said to him, "I do will it, be made clean." The leprosy left him immediately, and he was made clean. Then warning him sternly, he dismissed him at once. He said to him, "See that you tell no one anything, but go show yourself to the priest and offer for your cleansing what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The man went away and began to publicize the whole matter. He spread the report abroad so that it was impossible for Jesus to enter a town openly. He remained outside in deserted places, and people kept coming to him from everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord. Today we hear of Jesus healing the leper. We have to remember, whenever we see sickness in Scripture, it represents a broader illness. That's not only physical, but it's spiritual and it's personal. Among all the illnesses, leprosy was the worst. In the first reading, we hear that in biblical times, Moses said to the people that if someone has contracted leprosy, they should be put off to the side and not be allowed to go into the temple. They were not only unclean physically, they were unclean religiously. And then after they were cured, they were supposed to go first to the temple and thank God for the cure. This seems a bit heartless. But on another level, it was Moses and the leaders saying, "We must protect the people because an epidemic of leprosy could destroy everyone." Very harsh days. But Mark has got other things to say about leprosy, and that's why this story is so attractive. So now let's focus on the leper and how we can learn from his example. He does three things that we all need to learn to do ourselves. First, he comes to Jesus. Isn't that always the first step? Like us being here today, we've come to Jesus. You may ask why this is so important. God knows what we need already. I heard someone explain it this way in very simple terms. He said, you step, God steps. You don't step, God don't step. Seems very basic and simple, doesn't it? You make an effort, and God will be there for you. The second thing the leper does is he asks. He asks Jesus, if you wish, you can make me clean. What a great thing to ask for, to be made clean. Asking. Such an important step. It may be even more important today in our society, where it seems like some of the people think that they're entitled to everything and they don't need to ask. Part of receiving is asking. Even Jesus, during a couple of his miracles, would ask the person, what is it you would have me do for you? He would make them ask him. He already knew what they wanted, but he made them ask. So part of receiving the miracle is asking. I'm sure that asking with a sincere and contrite heart will also help. So let's do a quick review. The leper comes to Jesus, gets on his knees, and asks him to heal him. And Jesus reaches out to him and heals him. The leper stepped towards Jesus, and Jesus stepped toward the leper. So what's the third thing he does? This is the one that for me seems to be the hardest. God has blessed me and provided for me and guided me through so many situations. Yet I find this the most uncomfortable to do. The third thing he does is he goes and tells the whole world, even after Jesus tells him to tell no one. But that's what we need to be doing. Maybe this is part of our calling. Tell the whole world how Jesus has healed us. Tell the whole world about the miracles in your life. Tell the whole world how having Jesus in your life provides you with so much comfort and peace and joy. We should be energized and be just as appreciative and enthusiastic as the leper was about his life and the love that God shares with us. Jesus understood the leprosy of the leper, the darkness of the blind, the fierce misery of those who live for pleasure, and the strange poverty of the rich. Jesus stretches our capacity for compassion. He challenges our idea of what is true love. Each of us has a great capacity for love. The pity is that it often goes unused. We have in our power to reach out to those who are suffering the pain of rejection every day all around us. We could enkindle new hope. We could bring back the zest for living in someone else. And if we do, we mirror the infinite compassion of God. Our encounter with Christ is important, and we need to speak positively about the church and how enduring God's presence is in our world. Of course, our growing in the faith is the goal each day, but it's especially the goal of this special season that we're about to begin this coming Wednesday as we begin our annual pilgrimage of Lent. This is the reason why we undertake all of the penitential practices that we choose to do, so that we might be emptied of those things that can consume us or distract us, so that we may be filled with the grace and the love of God. St. Paul put it so simply in our second reading, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. That's our calling. That's our mission, to be agents of God's grace to all. So like the leper in our gospel today, we come here and we encounter the Lord, seeking his healing in all that can afflict us. We come here with confidence and with hope, with the sure knowledge that God will grant us his healing. Maybe not always the way we desire it, but always by the power of his love. Now let us be like the leper who publicized the whole thing, this wonder of life that God shares with us now. So like St. Paul, each day with great gratitude and with great joy, we may do all things for the greater glory of God. Jesus, I trust in you.
I believe in one God,
the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial to the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate and virgin to me, and became man. For our sake he was crucified on the cross of Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
Lord Jesus, who healed the leper, is ready to bring his grace to all those in need. Through him, therefore, we now pray to the Father.
That as the body of Christ, we may imitate our Lord's compassion in our lives by being instruments of God's mercy to those most in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that the Holy Spirit will touch the hearts of our nation's leaders, guiding them to govern with unity and peace as their goal, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
for an increase to the priesthood, religious life, and the diaconate, and that God will strengthen those who have chosen the married or single life as their vocation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that from conception to natural death, all people will be respected and given the dignity deserved as being created in the image and likeness of God, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
that each of us may be vigilant against the many temptations in our lives, and that we'll be open to God's healing power that flows through the sacraments, we pray to the Lord. For all who suffer in any way, and for all who have died, may they find peace in God's eternal love, we pray to the Lord.
Loving God, you provide for all our needs and are attentive to our prayers. As you bless us, may we proclaim your goodness to all our brothers and sisters. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Our presentation song is number 371, Bread of Life, number 371.
Change our hearts, beloved.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will the source of eternal reward, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right to give you thanks, truly just to give you glory, Father most holy. For you are the one God living and true, existing before all ages and abiding for all eternity, dwelling in unapproachable light. Yet you, who alone are good, the source of life, have made all that is, so that you might fill your creatures with blessings and bring joy to many of them by the glory of your light. And so, in your presence are countless hosts of angels who serve you day and night, and gazing upon the glory of your face, glorify you without ceasing. With them, we too confess your name in exaltation, giving voice to every creature under heaven as we acclaim. Father most holy, for you are great and you have fashioned all your works in wisdom and in love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when through disobedience he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death. For you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father, most holy, that in the fullness of time, you sent your only begotten Son to be our Savior. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor, he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners, freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart, joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life. And that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits of those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, O Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. And while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with the fruit of the vine, he gave thanks and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Celebrate the memorial of our redemption, and we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection, his ascension to your right hand, and as we await his coming in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, O Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one chalice, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Walker, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, that we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join in our communion song, number 474, In Every Age, number 474.
In every age, oh God. Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for that food by which we truly live, through Christ our Lord. At this point, I'll invite everyone to be seated for just a few moments. I'll invite Annette Ford. She's going to talk to us a little bit about our Lenten project with the Lenten boxes.
I have been asked to read a testimony from a student in our twin parish in Haiti and share some brief information about the Lenten box appeal done during Lent each year in our parish. The student wrote, "Good day to my friends at Divine Mercy. I am Carrie Delva. I am 18 years old, and I did all my primary and secondary studies at the St. John de Chantel School. My parents cannot afford to pay for my education, but thanks to your help, I am in my last year before graduating. The hot meal the school gives us helps us so much. I ask God to protect you and give you the strength to continue doing this work. As this student said, families cannot afford to pay for education. The average annual income in Haiti is $1,610, which makes it difficult for parents to provide for their family's needs. The testimony from our Twin Parish student commented on the thankfulness for the hot meal she receives each day. For many of the students, this may be their only meal that day. The investment that Divine Mercy Parish provides helps students receive an education that is key to overcoming their trials of poverty, hunger, illness, lack of shelter, and lack of material resources. The improvement of their circumstances needs to come from within, and that is what we can provide them. Our Twin Parish has three schools, which serves approximately 1,300 students. Through the Educate a Child program, you may contribute by using the Lenten boxes, which are at the exits. You can fill these with loose change during Lent, or at any time, you can always write a check and put it in the contributions with the memo, Educate a Child. All donations are tax deductible, and each family in the Bishop Garrigan system and in all of the faith formation classes will receive a box. Boxes can be returned to the church or parish office during Holy Week. But please remember, your support is making a difference in the lives of our brothers and sisters in Haiti, and every dollar goes directly to Haiti. From Proverbs, it says, "Whoever has a bountiful eye will be blessed, for he shares his bread with the poor." Thank you.
Thank you, Annette. And as Deacon talked about in the homily today, Wednesday starts Lent. It seems crazy. I feel like we just got done with Christmas, but now it's almost Ash Wednesday. And the three pillars of Lent are prayer, fasting, and almsgiving. Basically asking us the questions, fasting, you know, what are things that I can remove from my life to make more room for God? Prayer, how can I enter in a deep relationship with our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? And then almsgiving, how can I give of myself in this time, whether it be financially or time and talent and charitable works, how can I give of myself during these 40 days? And so I just invite all of you for the next 2.5 days as we get ready for Ash Wednesday to think and to pray about ways you can make this Lent as fruitful as possible as we move towards Easter. And so just an encouragement to take this time, these 40 days seriously as we move towards Easter. And just a few announcements for the week. First, please RSVP by Thursday for the Amore dinner. That'll be in Algona next week. It's an Italian-themed meal to support our youth ministry programs. Next Sunday from 5 to 8 in the Presentation Center. And like I said, it's by reservation only, so please make your reservations with the office or online. This February 22nd through the 24th at St. Michael's in Whittemore, the parish will be hosting a 40-hour Eucharistic devotion, including an evening meal, confessions, and talks by several of our priests from around the area. See the schedule in the bulletin and contact us if you would like to take an hour for the holy hour for those 40 hours, so we can make the adoration be continuous. And lastly, the Parish Families Against Hunger Pie fundraiser for food packaging is still in need of volunteers and donations of flour and sugar before next Sunday. See the bulletin for contact information and order your pies. Please stand. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Go in peace and glorify the Lord by your life.
Please join in our going forth song, number 392, Lord, You Give the Great Commission, number 392.